yourself laugh, joking by yourself. I think, like, I literally sit here, I could sit all day and just come up with the jokes, or just like watch something or listen to something, and just I am literally like laughing my butt off, and that makes me feel so good. It's just having fun with yourself, you know what I mean? Having fun with yourself and not taking yourself too seriously. And let's say if you're like out in public and you fall or something like that, because I'm so clumsy and I'm telling you guys, I fall all the time. But just laugh at yourself, don't take yourself too seriously. And I think that sometimes we take a lot of stuff in life for granted, and I just believe that we should in a way have more fun and be more charismatic with ourselves, and you know, stop trying to please everybody else and stuff like that. So yeah, it's very, very important. This is one of my favorite tips that I have also had to learn, was to forgive yourself. You should forgive yourself for all of the negativity that you let come into your life and you let stay and that you let settle. I think that you should forgive yourself for all of the toxic people, vibes, energy that you let come into your beautiful life and literally just take over in a way and change you. And like, is it just me, or sometimes when I've had that, people being very negative or toxic, it drains you and you find yourself becoming like really, like you're so drained and you're just like, because you've adapted to that negativity and that toxicness so much, and it literally, it drains you so much, and you just become so annoyed and aggravated with like people that you love, like maybe your parents or your siblings or other friends and stuff like that. So forgiveness, and also forgive yourself for things that you've done in the past. We're not perfect, we're all human, we've all done things, we've all said things, and I think it's important to forgive ourselves, you know what I mean, and genuinely take time to seriously forgive ourselves and let the past be the past, and we can only do better in the future and make sure that we live in the present moment. So one of my favorite tips that I actually do, I know this may sound corny, but I think that if you surprise yourself, surprise yourself by, you know, when you hear those stories of people ordering themselves flowers. I think that's so beautiful. Like, I literally, like, surprise yourself, treat yourself, basically, with, like, flowers or food, because I love food. But I think it's good to surprise yourself, because that makes you feel so good. You know what I mean? And it doesn't have to be, like, a big extravaganza, but you can just surprise yourself with maybe buying you flowers, or maybe buying yourself balloons, or if it's your birthday and you buy yourself a cake, surprise yourself. And of course, you know what it is, but still, just surprise yourself. I think that's so important, and I know a lot of people may think this is corny, but I've done it a couple of times, and you know, at first I was like, this is corny, why would I do that? But I'm telling you, like, I think it's beautiful, you know what I mean, and to each his own. But I think it's nice to surprise yourself, maybe treat yourself in some type of way, because you don't need anybody to do anything for you. I think that you should get up and go do it yourself. If you want self-love, you know, it's gonna take time, and of course it's easier said than done. But if you want to be happy in life, if you really want peace and joy and happiness inside of you, then do it. Writing things down. Now, I definitely have done this, where like maybe you have a journal or a diary and you literally write down all of your events that have occurred in the past, in the present, things that you want to happen in the future, and just write things down. And I know a lot of people so overwhelmed with like work and tests and quizzes and projects on the weekends, give yourself a break. Still get your work done, but I think it's very important to sometimes give yourself a break. Go and take a trip, you know, out the country, or you know, go in and just take a trip and just give yourself a break from life. I think that this, I know I'm saying that, I'm basically saying all my tips are important, but I think that a lot of the stuff is very important to give yourself a break and to heal mentally, emotionally, sorry, mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, energetically, maybe even financially. Just give yourself a break. If you need to take a break, maybe walk for a little bit, give yourself a breather, start your day over, take a nap, and just give yourself a break. Just give yourself time to really think about what you want out of life, and just breathe, okay? Because sometimes I really, 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 I need to do that more often. But definitely get back on the track right after you're done, you know, having your episode. And it's very normal and common for everybody to have episodes, because we're all humans. We all go through things. I think that we should all sometimes just sit back and just have a lot of gratitude towards everything. Sometimes I think that everybody in a way takes life for granted, and I think to myself that I'm in a bad situation, but somebody is in a even more worse situation than I am. And I think that sometimes we should just sit back and just be very grateful for what we have, you know. Just be grateful for your life, be grateful that you're alive and that you're happy and healthy, because some people did not wake up this morning, you know what I mean? And just be grateful that, you know, you have clothes on your back over your head, and grateful, be grateful, 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 and just have gratitude genuinely, and just show your appreciation. Like, let's say, like, if you have a parent, like your mom or your dad, that works extremely hard to, you know, provide for you, I think that right there, you need to show a lot of gratitude, and just be grateful for yourself, be grateful that you're alive, be grateful that you have vision, that you have sight, be grateful that you are protected. And I think gratitude is just an important figure in our life that we need to idolize more, if I'm using that word right. I think gratefulness, having gratitude, and being just like being so thankful is so, so, so important. I think it's so underrated. Like, just being thankful that you were able to wake up, leave your house this morning, and come back and be safe and be alive and be, nobody's guaranteed tomorrow, but, you know, in a way, be guaranteed tomorrow. You know how when you plan out stuff, like, okay, well, today's Thursday, okay, well, tomorrow I'm gonna do this. And it's like, in a way, you're guaranteed tomorrow, because some people, they are not guaranteed tomorrow, you know what I mean? So I think that's very important. My last thing, and then I think I'm gonna go, is, you know, you guys obviously watch me on YouTube now, and I'm very grateful for that. But I think with the generation that we live in, with cell phones and social media and all that stuff, I think sometimes you need to take a break from that. Like, sometimes I'll have to just get off of social media, you know, because it's a lot of fake stuff, and I need to get back to reality. I need to get back to what's real. And social media can be it's pros and cons to everything, and social media can be very toxic and a crazy place. And you know, sometimes you may be comparing yourself to another person because they may look this way, they may look that way, but you know, social media, everything is not real on social media, you know what I mean? It's a lot of editing, and I think it's just, like I said, take a break. You need to take a break from life, because take a break from social media. Even sometimes put your phone down and just maybe go take a walk or get something to eat, and maybe leave your phone at